The lining above the inlet level should be finished with a mortar. In the case of pit of large dimensions, the top portion may be narrowed to reduce the size of the RCC cover slab. Okay, means in case of dimension of the seepage pit or whatever soak pit is there is more, in that case at the top surface or whatever top portion is there, we can reduce its size, okay, by providing the RCC cover slab. Where no lining is used, especially near trees, the entire pit should be filled with loose stones. If our soak pit is near to the trees, then it is not necessary to go for the linings and all those things. Okay, just we have to fill up the loose stones in a soak pit. A masonry ring may be constructed at the top of the pit to prevent damage by flooding of the pit by surface runoff. Okay, means due to the runoff, to avoid the damage of the top surface of the pit, we can go for the provision of a masonry ring, okay, at top surface of the pit. Then when a disposal of septic tank effluent is to a dispersion trench, the dispersion trench shall be 0.5 meter to 1 meter deep and 0.30 meter to 1 meter wide excavated to a slight gradient, and shall be provided with 150 mm to 250 mm of washed gravel or crushed stones. Open jointed pipes placed inside the trench shall be of unglazed earthenware, clay or concrete, shall have a minimum internal diameter of 75 mm to 100 mm. Each dispersion trench shall not be greater than 30 meter, and trenches shall not be placed closer than 1.8 meter. Here they have given some guidelines regarding the dispersion trenches. Okay, as per that we have to go for it. But generally in a residential building, we are not going to use such kind of trenches and all those things. We are going to use the PVC pipes, okay, polyvinyl chloride pipes. Then next thing is their office cum letterbox room. In the case of multi-storied multi-family dwelling apartments constructed by existing and proposed comparative housing societies or apartment owners associations, limited companies and proposed societies, of office cum letterbox room of a dimension 3.6 meter by 3 meter shall be provided on the ground floor. In case of the member of a flats is more than 20, the maximum size of the office cum letterbox room shall be 20 meter square. Okay, this is related to the public. This is related to the apartments or corporative housing societies. Okay, means here at the ground floor level we have to provide the office cum letterbox room, and if the number of flats are less than 20, then we have to go for the provision of 3.6 meter to 3 meter as a floor area for office cum letterbox rooms. Okay, and if it is more than that, then we can go for up to the 20 meter also, 20 meter square floor area for office cum letterbox room. Then in case of business buildings, provision shall be made for letterbox on the entrance floor as per the requirements of the postal department. Okay, in case of business building, at the entrance only we have to provide the letterbox. Okay, or we can say office also, small office, okay, as per the requirement of the postal department. And then next thing is their meter room, okay, 12.17. Next thing is there, that is nothing but the staircase oblique exit requirements. Here the minimum width, minimum tread width and maximum rise of a staircases for buildings shall be as given 12.18.1.1 to 12.18.1.3. Okay. Also, they have given some guidelines in part 4 in fire and life safety. Okay. Of the same code. So, basically, whatever minimum width of the staircase, minimum, tread width, and maximum rise of staircase is mentioned here. They have given some guidelines regarding that. So we will discuss it. Minimum clear width. The following minimum width shall be provided for staircase for respective occupancies. If we are going to consider residential building, okay, in that for A2, then whatever minimum clear width is there of the staircase, it should be 1 meter. Then after that, in case of residential building under A1 category, A3 category and A4 category, okay, we have to provide at least minimum clear width of a staircase as a 1.25 meter. And whatever residential hotel, maybe in that under A5 and A6 category, we have to provide 1.5 meter distance as a minimum clear width of the stair. And wherever assembly building is there, okay, in that case, we have to provide 2 meter minimum clear width. One note is also they have given here, the width of stairs may be accepted to be 1.5 meter in case of assembly occupancy having less than 150 persons. Okay, if in assembly hall, if accommodates less than 150 number of persons, okay, then in that case, we can provide the width of the staircase as a 1.5 meter instead of 2 meter. Then also they have mentioned here for educational building, it should be 1.5 meter. Then for institutional building, it should be 2 meter. And for all other occupancies other than aforementioned, okay, for all the kind of buildings, it should be 1.5 meter. So these are the standard criterias regarding minimum clear width. Okay. Then next thing is there, minimum tread. The minimum width of tread without nosing shall be 300 mm. Here, whatever tread is there, tread is nothing but it's an horizontal surface of the step on which we are placing our foot. Okay, that is nothing but the tread, and whose width is there, it should not be less than 300 mm without consideration of nosing. Okay, nosing is nothing but whatever extended portion is there of the tread beyond the rise. Okay, that portion is nothing but the nosing, and without consideration of that portion, clearly we have to provide at least 300 mm as a minimum width of the tread. However, for one or two family dwelling, it may be reduced to not less than 250 mm. Okay, means here, whenever in case of two or one or two family dwelling are there, in that case, it may be reduced to less than 250 mm. Generally, in average, whatever length is there of our foot, okay, it will be 230 mm. That is nothing but the 9 inch. Okay, so put our foot safely on the tread, whose minimum dimension, whose minimum width is given as a 250 mm. Then next thing is there, it is related to the maximum rise. The maximum height of riser shall be 150 mm. The maximum height of riser shall be 150 mm. However, for one or two family dwelling, it may be increased to not more than 190 mm. The number of risers shall be limited to 12 per height. Per flight. Okay. Already we have discussed about these things in a staircase, stair design, in a building construction and drawing. Okay. So here, if we are considering only one family or two families are there, in that case, we can increase the riser up to 190 mm. Okay. Because of traffic will be less in that case, means whatever staircase is there, we are using occasionally, not at each and every time we are using that staircase for circulation, means we are not going to up and down or whatever flow is there. Okay, and that flow will be of limited persons, those who are inmates, or sometimes if guests came in that particular family or in that particular building, then and then only they are going to use. Means we can consider they are using occasionally only. Okay, so we can increase that riser up to 190 mm. But in public building, whatever flow is there, traffic is there of persons of any age group will be there. Okay. And more traffic will be there. Density of traffic will be more. So to avoid the accidents and to avoid the difficulties at the time of rising at the time of circulation, we have to provide maximum 150 mm as a rise. Okay, the number of risers shall be limited to 12 per flights, means whatever number of steps are there in a one flight should not be less than 12 and should not be more than 12 and should not be less than 3. That is the criteria. Okay, with that criteria we have to go for. Then the minimum headroom in a passage under the landing of a staircase shall be 2.2 meter. The minimum clear headroom in any staircase shall be 2.2 meter. Means here whatever headroom is there, okay, that headroom we have to maintain as a 2.2 meter. I think already I told you in case of a spiral staircase, we have to increase the height of riser, okay? Because of, we have to maintain that headroom also. The headroom in a staircase should not be less than 2.2 meter. So whatever steps are there, one over the above, okay, exactly one over the above. So whatever vertical distance is there, that should be of 2.2 meter. And to maintain that we have to increase the height of riser in case of a spiral staircase. But in other type of staircases, the height of riser should not be more than 150 mm in case of public building, and in case of residential building, maybe fewer one or two family or dwellings are there, in that case we can increase up to the 190 mm. Okay, then exit requirements. All aspects of exit requirements for corridors, doors, staircase, ramps, etc., in respect of width, travel distance, shall be as per part 4, okay, fire and life safety of the code. Whenever we are going to discuss about the I think unit number 7, okay, in the at that time we will discuss about the width and travel distance for doors, rooms, and whatever exits we are going to provide it. Okay, so one logic is behind that, whatever inmates are there or whatever occupants are there, they should leave their places as early as possible in the event of a fire. Okay, that is the thing behind it. Okay, so that thing we have to consider it, and we have to provide the access or exit to each and every occupant. Then next thing is there, that is nothing but the roofs. The roof of a building shall be so designed and constructed as to effectively drain water by means of sufficient rainwater pipes of adequate size wherever required, so arranged, jointed, and fixed as to ensure that the rainwater is carried away from the building without causing dampness in any part of the walls, roof, or foundation of the building or an adjacent building. Okay, here whatever roofs are there upper buildings, we have to so designed and constructed in effectively manner with consideration of the drain water. Okay, means whatever rainwater harvesting is there, as early as possible we have to go for the rainwater harvesting. Means whatever rainwater is there on roof surface, it should harvest as early as possible. Then the authority may require rainwater pipes to be connected to a drain or sewer to a covered channel formed beneath the public footpath to connect the rainwater pipe to the road gutter or in any other approved manner. Okay, means suppose we have to directly connect the rainwater pipes to the drain or sewer line, then we have to take the prior permission. Okay, means we have to mention those things in our building permission drawing and whatever related documents are there. Okay, then rainwater pipes shall be affixed to the outside of the external walls of the building or in recesses or chasses cut or formed in such external walls or in such other manner as may approved by the authority. Okay, means whatever rainwater pipes are there, we have to fix it to the external walls, outside the external walls of the building or wherever we are going to provide the recessions and all those things. Okay, to that portion we have to provide the rainwater pipes. Then it is desirable to conserve rainwater using suitable rainwater harvesting technique, including by roof water collection. Okay, means also you can go for the implementation of rainwater harvesting concept. Either we have to collect that roof water into the big tank. We have to by constructing that big tank at the basement, okay, or whenever we require the water, or whenever we feel scarcity of water, at that time we can use that water, or directly we can release that rainwater into the borewell or open well also, okay. So whatever groundwater table is there, it will get recharged.